Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be teaching you about the Yamaha DM3-D and how to connect that to a Tio1608-D stage box. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. Also, if you're looking for weekly audio tips and tricks, I have a newsletter that is free that you can sign up for at audiotoolkit.co. So head over there, and then you will get a weekly tip from me on audio and all the things around audio just to help gain a little bit more knowledge for the community. Now let's go ahead and dive in and see how we actually get the Yamaha DM3 connected with a Tio stage box. Now the Yamaha DM3 can be a 96K or a 48K sample rate. So that means that this can utilize the new D2 Tios. But in my studio here, I have the original, the Yamaha Tio1608-D, which is a 48K sample rate Dante device. So if I want to connect my DM3 to this older Tio, then I need to change the sample rate of my Yamaha DM3 to be 48K. And so to do that, we want to go ahead and press the gear icon and then go to word clock, and we can choose between 96K or we can choose to 48K. And in this case, we want to select the 48 kilohertz because I'm wanting to connect to this older stage box. Now, if we had a D2, then I'd want to connect to the 96K. Now, one thing to note about Dante is we cannot mix and match 96K and 48K on the same network. The 96K devices won't be able to see the 48K devices, but the 48K can see each other, and the 96K can see each other, but they won't be able to see each other. So I wouldn't be able to connect my DM3 to a 96K stage box if this is set to 48K. So if you're deciding to connect to multiple devices, you would need to have all of the devices on that Dante network set to the same sample rate. So in this case, I have 48K selected. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to close out of this and go into my Dante setup. Now, our Dante setup has a few different options. Now, on the back of the Yamaha DM3, there is a primary and a secondary port. Now, there's two ways that we can configure these ports to work. One is a daisy chain, where that means that my primary port is going to be the primary port for us, and our secondary port will loop through all of the data that's coming in on the primary port, allowing us to plug in another device. So for instance, if I was doing this in a small corporate setup where I had my Tio up on stage, this at front of house, and my computer to the left of me, I could then set this up as a daisy chain mode, meaning that I can have my primary port go and connect into my Tio, and then my secondary port I can plug into my computer using Dante Virtual Sound Card and have all of the data available to all three devices through my switched mode that's on my primary secondary, or called daisy chain. Now, the other mode that we can set up is a redundant mode. Now, the redundant mode means that my primary port would need to be plugged into the primary port of my Tio. My secondary port would also need to be plugged into the secondary port on my Tio. Now, this makes it so that if my primary network dies or fails, then it would automatically switch over to the secondary network instantly. Now, if you are utilizing a primary and secondary redundant network, and you have network switches installed in between these two devices, you would actually have to have two separate network switches, because a secondary set up as redundant and a primary, those two ports cannot live on the same network. In fact, if you accidentally plug in a secondary redundant network into a primary switch, you will actually crash the Dante network, which is no good. So you need to decide, are we going to set up a switched network or are we going to set up a redundant network? So if you only have one stage box and no other devices that you need to connect, then do a redundant network if you want to have that extra redundancy. Or if you want to have a quick setup and not have the redundancy, you can go ahead and set that up in the daisy chain or switched mode network. And so in this case, I'm going to go ahead and just set this up as a switch mode daisy chain network. Now, On the DM3, in our Dante setup, we can choose between a daisy chain or redundant on our secondary port here. Now, if we do change this over, there is about a 40 to 50 second wait time that you have while the Dante network resets itself. Now, we have some other options here. We have our latency, which gives us the ability of having a faster or a more latent network. Now, this is beneficial if you have a very large network going through a lot of different switches. And Dante has a great article on Audinate's website that will go through how to set this. But in our case, I can go ahead and leave this at 1. Now, our bit rate, we can choose between a 24-bit or a 32-bit audio setup. 32-bit is going to have more network data over your network. So if you do set this up to 32, make sure that your network can support the extra bandwidth that's going to be taken up by having that extra audio samples in your audio. So in this case, I'm just going to leave it at 24. And then we want to make sure that this is the preferred leader, meaning that this is the main master device setting the clock rate for your Dante network. If you were setting this up with multiple DM3s, then you would want to have one DM3 as the primary, or even a Ravage or a DM7. You want to have one console be the primary leader for the Dante network, and then all the rest of the devices are going to be secondary, chaining themselves to the clock rate of that primary device. Because we only have one console and one stage box, I'm going to leave the preferred leader as on. Now, the next thing that we have is our Dante patch. Now, there's a few things that I need to set up on my Tio before I go into the Dante patch, but I'm going to grab my Dante cable and plug it into the primary and then go over to my Tio and get some settings set up there. So I'm at the back of my Yamaha Tio1608-D, and there's a few settings that I want to set. Now, we can see that there's a fan switch here, which we can set to high or low, and I always leave that on high. But we have our Dante ports here, so we have our primary and our secondary port. Now, if we have our dip switches here, when we start up the unit, I want to have all of these in the up position. Now, if this is going to be your first time setting up your TO with your DM3, you want to have all of these in the up position. Now, we have the ability of having our secondary port be a daisy chain, where I can connect my primary Dante port into my primary port here, and then I can utilize the secondary as a loop through to be able to connect my next Dante device and have them all be on the same network through one cable coming from the other Dante device going into here, and then this going to my mixer. Now, the other option that I have is having my secondary port be a redundant network, meaning that I would connect two cables, one from the primary here to the primary on the DM3, and then my secondary port, I would connect a cable from my secondary port here into this secondary port on the DM3-D. Now, the thing that I would need to do is I would need to change my dip switch settings here to be on redundant. And so I would go to my dip switch 4 and I would turn that to down. Now, by doing this, what it happens is it sets up the two ports of Dante to be a redundant network. That way, if my primary network died, my secondary network would pick up. Now, if you have network switches in between this device and your DM3, then you would need to have two dedicated switches in between this device and your DM3. You cannot take your primary and secondary and put them into the same switch and have a secondary network. In fact, if you plug in a secondary into a primary switch, it actually can take down the entire Dante network, which is bad. So if you're planning on using this as a primary and secondary network, then you'd want to have your secondary port set as redundant. If you're planning on just using it as a daisy chain and only utilizing one network switch, then you want to have this little switch up. Now then, the other option that we have is our startup mode. Now, refreshes the settings on the TO every time you boot it up. Resume, if you have this set to the first dip switch on 7 down, resume resumes the previous settings that the Tio had the last time it was powered up. So again, if this is your first time setting it up, I suggest having this to be up. And that way, every time that this boots up, it's going to refresh and want to get its settings every time. Now, once you have this already connected, then it's a good idea to go ahead and set this to resume. That way, it will always reconnect to the same thing as you want. So once you have these things set, we want to go ahead and turn off the unit and then turn it back on. And then we want to go ahead and plug in our primary into our primary here. Now there's a few other settings that we need to set before we can get this connected into our Yamaha DM3. And one thing that we want to set is our unit ID. Now our unit ID can be 1, even though the console is set to 1 as well. And in fact, this is going to be the quickest way to set up your Tio, is by having your unit ID set to 1. And then we want to have quick config turned on, and then our 48 volt master turned on. Now if we turn our 48 volt master off, then that means that none of the phantom power of our unit will actually work, so we want to go ahead and turn that on. Now once you have unit ID set to 1, our quick config set to on, and our 48 volt master set to on, we want to go ahead and power cycle, so we can turn it off, and then we can turn this unit back on. Now then, the rest of the things that we need to do is actually over on our Yamaha DM3. So let's go ahead and jump over there and we can get the rest of this set up. Now that we're back at the DM3, I'm going to go into my Dante patch. And what's great about this is this shows me all the Dante patch that's here. Now, if you do happen to have something saved in here already, what you can do is go to Library and you can go and recall your initial data, which clears all the Dante patches. And then we can just go ahead and press Recall, and it's going to say Recall Dante Patch, and we'll press OK. Now, that will then apply and wipe out all of the Dante patches that you have on the DM3. Once we have that, then we can go ahead and close out. And then we can go to auto setup. Now, once we press auto setup, it's going to scan the network for any Dante devices. Now, because we only have our Tio1608-D on this Dante network, it's automatically going to pull up all of our Dante patch for patching this network. So we can see that our ins 1 through 16 are going to come from the Tio in 1 through 16. And then we can see that our outputs are automatically going to be assigned. Once we have that, we can go ahead and press apply. And then we will press apply one more time. And then this will go through and actually make all of those Dante patches. Now, if you have Dante controller, you could also make these patches via Dante controller, but this is just for the internal portion of the mixer if we didn't want to open up Dante controller. Now, once we have that set, we can go ahead and press close. And we can go ahead and X out of this. Once we have that closed, we can go into our IO device and we can see that we have a patch device here. And we can see that it's a Tio1608-D. We can see the Dante name of it. And we can even see the version firmware and the Dante firmware that's installed on the Dante chip of this device. Now, if we have multiple devices on our Dante network and we are looking for this specific Tio, what we can do is we can press and hold identify and it will flash the lights on the front of the Tio, showing you which device this is. Now that we have that set, we can go ahead and X out of this, and then we want to go into our patching. Now that we have our Dante settings set, let's actually go ahead and patch our Dante to our channels inside the DM3. Now we can go and click on the gear icon here and then go to patch. Now if we're planning on using only the Dante channels coming from our Tio into our 16 mono channels of the DM3, then there is a quick tip that I have. As we're patching this, what we can do is we can swipe from the right hand side and we can just select all Dante. Now this will change all of our patching from channels 1 through 16 to be from our Dante network. And then we can see that we now have our Dante for all of our channels 1 through 16. Now, if you're only wanting to have a couple of your channels from Dante, we can go ahead and swap this back to be from all input. And then we can just go ahead and define the channels that we want to. So for instance, channel 1, I'm going to pull from Dante 1. And so once we have that set, we can go into our channels, press home, and we can go ahead and test the mic that we have. So I'm going to go into my input settings here and start adjusting this gain up. So check 1, 2, check, check, check. Hey, 1, 2, 1, 2. And then we can go ahead and put that up in our main left, right, and we can hear this microphone. Now, one tip that I have is if you are utilizing all 16 inputs on the back of your board, but you're not utilizing your stereo playback, one thing that you can do is you can use your stereo in channel via Dante. So for instance, if I had all of my channels in my patch on input 1 through 16, and then what I can do is I can go over to my stereo channel and I can change this to be from Dante in. So here we go and go choose Dante 1, and on my stereo in 2, we can choose Dante 2. And so at this point, if I go over to my stereo channel on my effects mon layer, we can go ahead and turn this up, check 1, 2, and we can hear me on the left-hand side only here. Now, the other tip that I have is if you're utilizing a setting that doesn't actually use your effects. So you're doing a mix and you're not even using any of your effects for this show. This is going to be perfect for corporate stuff. Is you can actually change the routing for your effects returns to be also from Dante. So, for instance, if I wanted to, I can go to my effects 1 and set this to be from Dante 3, and on this one, Dante 4. And then we can go to my effects 2, and we can do effects 2 as Dante 5 and Dante 6. Now what we've just done is we've set it so that all 16 channels, 1 through 16, are on the XLRs on the back of this board, as well as our effects and monitor section. We have our stereo playback channel as Dante 1, 2. We have our effects return as Dante 3, 4, and our effects return 2 as Dante 5, 6. So we can actually have three stereo channels of Dante from our Tio into our board. So this is just one extra little tip that you can do of having all of these settings on the DM3. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or if there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the DM3, or really any of the other production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.